everybody. Team Bravo 615 here. And today, let's play some more Life is Strange. Where we last left off, we just discovered that Dana, the silly little minx, grabbed out the thumb drive from our room that we had to get over to Warren. Now, plot twist, Dana was locked in her room by Juliet Watson. I actually guessed her last name. I have not played this game in 7 years, so there was no way in hell I was going to remember her last name. So that was actually pretty awesome that on the first guess I got it right. Not like there's any penalty, really, but with the art. Man, if I could edit that to sound all booming and echoing, that would have been epic. Ooh, future me. Or past me, I hope you did that. Anyway, so now we have been tasked with going yet again. Love these fetch quests. It is Squaresoft, so yeah. Fetch quest. Or I guess for you newbies, Square Enix. So this is Square Enix still? I thought it was Square. Square Enix, right? Yeah, Square Enix. Okay. I have just conferred with the waifu slash my assistant, my lovely assistant, that yes, it is indeed Square Enix. But yet again, another fetch quest courtesy of Square Enix to find the proof in Victoria's room that will set Dana free. So now here we are in the belly of the beast, as it were, to find the proof that we need. God, I do not miss high school. Ooh, let's go. Okay, here we are. Well, at least she keeps a clean room. No drawers or nothing, nowhere, no bras anywhere. This is not in an appropriate room. Good. So, let's do our famous right to left, shall we? We have some fototos. No, we're not leaving yet. We need proof.
Speaking of selfies.
You know what? I don't want to play the bitch in this. I can rewind this. I should be able to rewind this if I do this. Okay, fine.
Let's play a little photo Tetris and leave Victoria a message. Let's move this here and this one there. A pattern is emerging.
That is pretty funny. Can I take a photo of it? I can take a photo of it. And I'm guessing I have a picture of that. I do. but as much fun as that is, let's not, okay? I will fight the urge.
Whoa, I had no idea Victoria's parents owned the Chase space. Color me impressed.
I don't know what the Chase space is. I'm sure it's something to do with Seattle arts and whatnot. So we'll run with that.
Ouch. Well, at least she puts her photographs out there. Unlike me.
Dear Ms. Chase, thank you for your submission to the Croft Gallery. Unfortunately, your work is not compatible with our mission statement. We appreciate your effort and wish you success in future endeavors. Best, Amanda Croft, owner Croft Gallery, Eugene, Oregon. Well, that sucks for her. But like she said, at least she's actually trying.
She's actually got a classic medium format camera with some awesome prime lens. I hate you, Victoria.
Now. Let's not be jealous.
No, doesn't fit. I'm not snooping. Just admiring Victoria's cutting edge tech.
With my fingers.
Is she going to get a 3D printer for her dorm room? Maybe I will join her posse.
Oh, $3,600 for a 3D printer. I'm betting, well, I don't know. I guess now the prices might have come down since then. You figure this is back, I don't even think it was 2017. I probably played this even, this game probably came out before that. I think 10 years ago. So I'm sure by now the prices have come down a little bit. It's not as impressive as it was back then.
They should call this series aloof. Cold and soulless. Kind of like Victoria.
Now.
Yes, I get it. Enter the Vortex Club. No.
No. No Vortex
okay,
for you.
If I did wear expensive jewelry, I would wear this for sure.
Rather handy having it all in that little bowl holder thing you do. I just kind of keep, not that I wear excessive amounts of jewelry, but I do have a few necklaces and rings and such. I don't really have them
Victoria
organized.
Victoria has the best retina screen laptop. Let me just check to see if she posted my picture.
She said she wasn't going to.
I'll give Victoria props for not posting my photo. And for this nice shot.
Okay, well, see.
Boom. This is the email I need to show Juliet. Now I have to print this fast and get the hell out of here.
So sad to inform you that I totally punked Juliet and Dana just now. All I had to do was mention to Juliet that I saw a nasty sext from Dana on Zach's phone. Dumbass, believe me, and so I expect there may be a dorm rampage soon. Juliet deserves this for slutting Zach away from me. As for Dana, who gives a shit? Get out your popcorn. Ah, golly. Fucking high school drama. Didn't have all this tech back then when I was in high school. Back in my day, we just wrote notes back and forth.
Victoria is a real Jefferson groupie.
Well, I did. I know she was trying to get in Mr. Jefferson's pantaloons.
Victoria is a real
I
Jefferson
I just read
groupie.
That. I'm not trying to look at that. Is that what I was trying to look at?
Victoria is a real Jefferson
yes.
groupie.
In case you needed to hear it for the third time. Oh, international photographer Mark Jefferson. Local, the Bean Hip Cafe. Bring this ad for $1 off. Okay, I guess she is a groupie. Really? What do you have
Victoria
the poster?
Victoria hates Rachel Amber this much?
Wow.
How insecure.
That's a bit excessive, yeah. That is a bit excessive, I have to admit. You know, you don't know what happened to the girl, man. She might be fucking dead for all you know.
I bet Victoria put Juliet on her shit list after this article.
Is the Vortex Club a... I guess that's probably why. Is this Vortex Club a cult? By Juliet Watson. One of Blackwell Academy's most durable and influential social groups, the Vortex Club, started in the neon 1980s as a new wave rebellion against the yuppie forces of the Reagan era. Imagine a time when computer nerds were dumped into garbage cans and blue hair was a cause for expulsion and even violence. Male students who wore earrings were bullied and beaten. Now every football player has two or three exotic piercings. So the Vortex Club was originally a haven from the peer pressure that every generation experiences. How ironic that the revolutionary roots of social misfits has become what some students claim is an elitist cult. Or is this just envy at one of Blackwell's most successful organizations? We tried to interview the Vortex Club member Victoria Chase, but she refused to comment and even tried to stop the story from publication. Okay, that would be why. I'll look at that in a second. I want to keep looking around.
That is a tasty plasma. Maybe I could sneak in and watch Final Fantasy Spirits Within. I don't care what anybody says. That's one of the best sci-fi films ever made.
Shameless plug. Square Enix. How could you? Wow. Look, I'm a Final Fantasy groupie, and I have to admit, that movie was bad. It wasn't horrible, but it was bad. I enjoyed it either way because I like kitschy shit, but that was
bad. Oh man,
bad.
This is so wrong. I better find proof fast.
Don't rush me.
Those boots are made for walking runways.
I will find my proof when I can.
You could pay for my tuition with that wardrobe.
All right. Fine. Getting all nervous. Let me grab the friggin' email.
This isn't even recycled paper. Victoria's not doing her part to save the Earth. But this is for a good cause, too.
All right.
This better convince Juliet that Dana is innocent.
And let's see how it goes from here. Anything else? Anything else? There's me in the mirror. I have to admit, I'm mildly amused by games that have the player character's reflection in mirrors, because there are way too many games where the mirrors have no effect at all, and the physics just breaks my brain. Okay, really, across the hall? Jesus. Can I do anything else with that slate? No. No, not now. Busy. I have something for you. Juliet.
Juliet, read this. Of course.
Duh.
I'm an asshole. I'm sorry, Dana. You are. And I hope so. You really think I'd mess around with Zachary?
No, but I get stupid jealous. I owe you dinner. Still love me?
And you do my laundry.
Thanks, Max. You're like the Blackwell Ninja. Now let's see what Zach has to say about Victoria.
You set me free. Thank you. Warren's flash drive is on my desk.
Why do you want her to do your laundry? That's a bit excessive, I think. I don't want anyone else seeing my drawers.
Get the flash drive, and then I'll go see Warren.
All right. I'll be with you in a second. I need to also explore this room. Just don't get all creeped out that I'm checking things out here.
I can't even imagine what life would be like being a cheerleader. Dramatic, I guess.
Case in point.
Dana takes her Blackwell spirit seriously.
Go Bigfoots. 07? Wow. Okay, so older still. Never mind. Flash drive. Still looking around. Don't mind
me.
This
is both sad and pathetic.
Dana, I suck at writing, but I thought I should write this, so you might not hate my dumbass forever. I know I act like a tough jock around everybody, but I never had to act around you. I'm not the kind of man you deserve. You saw how I passed out? If you need any money, let me know. Huh? Oh, pussed out. Okay. Pussed out. Oh, my.
That looks like a home pregnancy test.
Why would I take that? Why would I even think to take that?
This is both sad and pathetic.
Why would I even think to take that?
Ooh, Dana's Facebook wall is up and running. I shouldn't look.
I shouldn't look, but I could. All right. Dana, is everything okay
Dana
with you?
Dana really does look stressed about all this.
Hey, Dana.
Seriously, thanks again. I can't believe Juliet locked me in my own room. Real mature.
Victoria is not nice. Yeah, we'll go that route.
Victoria is not nice. I don't get it. She has everything. And to pull that prank on a friend?
Just because they're in the Vortex Club doesn't mean they're BFFs. I'm in it, and Victoria creeps me out. Max, you're smart to be a loner here. Though, Warren obviously likes hanging with you.
What do you mean? Sure, what do you mean?
Oh, nothing. When you opened the flash drive, didn't you see the special folder called Max?
Yeah, okay. I gotcha.
Are you blushing? Go ahead and grab the flash drive whenever.
She wasn't blushing. Was she blushing? I don't think she was blushing.
It would be a cool sticker without the words.
Would I'd probably piss her off, but I could just rewind it. Do I really want to take that? I don't think I want to take that. That's a bit much.
There's that damn flash drive.
There's the damn flash drive.
Must protect my precious so Max never has to chase it down again.
Do you mind if I use my flash drive here, Miss Lady?
I better make sure everything is still in there. I think Warren forgot to hide the Party Buster folder. Not that I would open it, no matter how tempting. I have my self-respect.
The party, but unholy obscenities? Oh, boy. There, I have no words. But, yeah, there is the folder. Max, no kidding. Okay. Can I take it back? I think I already took it back. Let's see. She's probably going to bitch me out, but I'm going to take a look real quick.
Of course a popular cheerleader like Dana would have a million friends. It's so fascinating to get a peek into Dana's social media world. And yes, Max, so terribly wrong.
So terribly wrong. But not a million. She only has 1,083 friends. Nowhere near as many as I have anyway. Ha! You're right. But why is that... Why would I even think to take that? I don't know. That's a bit much for me, and I'm sure that would most def piss her off. Is there a way? I'm gonna try. You know what? I'm gonna see if it unlocks any kind of dialogue with her. I can always rewind it. It's like, hey, what the fuck you doing? Grabbing my shit.
Max, that's mine. Thank you.
Yeah,
you're
a bit
helpful. You're just nosy. I think you better go.
Yep, I knew that. I actually wanted to do.
You hurt her feelings by being so damn nosy again. But I could rewind and make it up to her.
You could. Let's do that. Come on, rewind faster.
Hey, Dana.
I heard a rumor about you. Oh my.
Dana. I'm not trying to be nosy, but I heard a rumor about you.
What? Who told you I was pregnant?
Nobody important. They just acted like it was bullshit. I just wanted you to know.
It's like a goddamn reality show around here. Can you keep a secret, Max?
Of course.
I was pregnant. Was.
Oh, wow. Oh.
What about the other?
That'd be Dad? You can catch him on the 40-yard line this Friday. And it's not Zachary.
Do I want to get all that? I mean, I said I could keep a secret, but... let's see.
Who then? And you don't have to tell me. In fact, you better not.
I like your spirit, Max. Anyway, you better get that flash drive so Warren has an excuse to bug you.
All right, well, at least it wasn't that bad. How sad, though. Maternity book.
Good Lord. Dana really was on her own.
Oh. She was actually gonna... Dana. Clinic note.
I assume Dana kept the appointment.
Oh. October 2nd. Okay. Well, I'm assuming because Zach pussed out like he put. Okay. Oh, I'm coming, Warren, you needy fuck. Anyway. Let's see. Get ready, hope so. Okay. I don't mind waiting out here forever. I love this parking lot. I can count all the cars. The more I text, the longer I take. On my way. Bye. Oh, Dana. Poor Dana. Let's look at the map again.
Blackwell isn't that big, but it sure feels like a labyrinth. Welcome to Black Hill.
Let's see. Oh, Red Rum is Stella's. Okay. I could have probably have been able to tell all that. All right, leaving the dorms. All righty.
This shit.
Ow!
Damn, I better rewind.
Poor lady.
Fuck this shit.
Let's try a little bit faster.
I feel like Alyssa and I should be better friends.
I don't mean to keep repeating her getting hit.
Alyssa, move your head.
If you insist, Max.
Ooh.
Now that's what I'm talking about. I actually helped somebody.
Max, that was awesome. Thank you.
You're welcome.
No problem. You have quick reflexes.
Years of mad dodging skills. Well, these never change.
That's why you're better off.
You're smart. We should hang out more. Now I have to finish this stupid book.
I love her hair. I got a text from Victoria. Why did I get a text from Victoria? BTW, thanks, but we're not friends. Okay, cool. What's up with this dude? Oh, you're Zachary.
I could almost feel sorry for him if he wasn't such a serious dick. Poor Juliet.
Get lost, hipster. I'm not doing any interviews.
Wow. Well, fuck you and all. Well, I see Kate's gone.
Glad to see our campus is eco-friendly.
Okay. Hey, I might have missed my shot. Because I know there was a way. But see, Kate was there. There was no way. Oh, well. Don't mind me taking the tour, people.
Glad to see our campus is eco-friendly.
I already said that.
Now that's what I call instant karma.
I wonder who's, room that is. You know, it'd be funny if that was actually Victoria's room. I probably could go back in to check, but I'm not gonna. All right, fuck off, Zach. Off to the parking lot. Oh.
So don't think I'm blind. I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, and leave me alone.
Well, dude, what the fuck? Why her?
Hey, why don't you leave her alone?
Excuse us. This is official campus business.
Excuse me. You shouldn't be yelling at students or bullying them.
Hey, nobody is bullying anybody. I'm doing my job.
No, you're not.
You're part of the problem, Missy. I will remember this conversation.
You remember it with your grump ass.
Oh, Max, that was great. I think you scared him for once. I have to go, but thank you. It means a lot.
Anytime, Kate.
I helped my friend.
I felt like an everyday hero helping Kate, but now Officer David Dickhead is after me. Maybe I should rewind and mind my own business?
Well, hang on a second. Is that a... I'm assuming it's a picture. Ah! Show me picture. No. I'm still here, right? I'm here? No. Here? No. Oh, maybe it's not. It is, isn't it? No, it's not. Oh, okay. Well, then, no. I wouldn't put her through that. The hell with that. No, that's fine. David Dickhead can piss off. Flash drive in my hand. Oh, yeah, I called it earlier. I called it a thumb drive. Sorry. It was a very loud squirrel. Sound like a bird. Hey, Hey, Juliet's
I'm glad
here too.
I stepped in that time. Can't stand to see people being bullied.
Seriously, fuck bullies.
I better go there soon to see if Joyce is still there. And get a burger.
All about the burgers. Cars equal death.
Good thing I don't have a car. Yet.
Good lord. That's a bit excessive, I think. Oh, this poor bike.
Who toilet papers a bike?
Seriously. Bunch of hooligans in this damn town. Whose truck? Before I go out that way, let me go see what's up with Julia first.
I don't get it. How could Zach and Victoria do that to me?
Juliet still looks upset about Zach and Victoria. I don't blame her. Hi, Juliet. How are you doing?
Oh, hey, Max. Sorry, I'm still screwed up.
Sorry you had to find out about Zachary that way. Or anyway.
Better sooner than later. Now that skank Victoria won't be laughing behind my back anymore.
Have you talked to Zach yet?
Mr. Badass Football Hero is such a chicken shit. He said he sexted Victoria as a joke. Ha ha. I think Warren wants your attention.
He usually does. Hang in there, Juliet.
See you around, Max.
Yep, there he is, just staring me down.
I wonder how long before Samuel has to repaint that.
That's not nice. Poor Samuel. More missing persons posters. I'll be right with you, Warren. Just stare at my ass as I walk around the parking lot.
Now this really pisses me off. So entitled. Sorry, handicapped folks. My truck needs these two spots more than you do. Bastard.
Seriously, what a dick. Someone should flatten their tires. Wish I could. Why is there a camper on campus? Oh, hello, doggo. Oh, are you... I just realized hopefully my dog doesn't freak out. Are you friendly?
That dog looks peaceful asleep, but if I get too close... Cujo.
Yeah, but seriously, who the hell has a camper?
That layer of dust is begging for my finger.
Yes, it is.
It's not a dirty window unless somebody writes clean me on it.
This action will have consequences.
I could use this picture for a series on Arcadia Bay lots.
I am so dirty. There it is. Not too bad, not too bad. I mean, what consequences could this actually have? I drew on a window. It's not like I fucking broke it. That's a nice truck.
Get your ass over here.
I'll get over there when I get a second there, Warren. Jesus. You know, it's not cute when guys are needy. Just saying.
Look at Warren in his Wayback Machine. He's a brave man.
That's actually a pretty cool car, as a matter of fact. All right, what? What do you want? What?
And there's Warren. Did he actually buy a used car?
I guess this is supposed to be his.
What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash.
Oh, thanks. My.
No problem.
Trying to go in for the hug, I see.
Cool. Very old school.
1978, to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in. There's one in Newburgh just 60 miles away.
You're in the wrong time, Warren. But then, so am I.
You okay?
It's been one strange fucking day.
I bet.
I have powers.
I got a face full of paint. I'd pay money to see a photo of that.
If I had the picture, which I don't, because I'm not that big of a dick. Nah, I don't want to.
I don't want to talk about it.
Jeez, you're a little missensitive today.
I wouldn't push your luck, Warren. Not in the mood today.
By the way, I saw Daniel's sketch of you online. Not bad, but I could do a much better job.
Oh my.
You can draw? I thought you were blinded by science, not art.
Art is science. Music is math, etc., etc. I'd put Stephen Hawking against Picasso any day.
Hardcore. So you must use a computer to draw.
Of course. I'd love to tweak one of your selfies with some cool graphics.
That might not suck. I'll let you know.
So, did you get a chance to check out the movie booty on my flash drive?
Yeah. Why not? Sure.
Thanks. You had some cool shit on there, from Akira to Twilight Zone.
Akira was awesome.
I consider myself a pop cultural pirate connoisseur.
That does sound better than thief.
Ha ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
Could say seen it. I've heard of it. I've never seen it. We'll go, why not? No fucking way.
No fucking way will I watch that. My mind is twisted enough.
I laughed my ass off.
So you're sensitive.
Ouch, that sounds awful the way you say it.
Faster, pussycat, kill, kill. I actually know that from the memes.
No, I was impressed you had faster, pussycat, kill, kill.
Russ Meyer was a genius of black and white. Plus, babes with breasts.
Who
oh, Lord.
Who would get your sensitive ass down?
If I was lucky. Speaking of hip and fast, we should cruise out in my car to an actual movie this week. But
yes,
you seem distracted.
Actually, what she would love to do after hearing you talk about big tits. Yeah, let me tell you. Don't want to speak about it. I need to talk. But do I want to talk to Warren? He might be able to be serious, aside from trying to get down her pants. Maybe. Question mark? I don't know. Let's see.
I need to talk to somebody, just to get it out of my system.
Dr. Warren Graham is in the house. I won't even prescribe you any meds. Tell me everything.
Oh, boy.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me, not social media.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right? You're one of the Jeffersons' photo groupies?
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you told the principal, now.
Answer I told him the truth.
I told him the
Excuse
truth.
You,
the student
dick.
Had a gun.
No, you told him I had a gun. That's why he dragged me into his office.
And did what, give you a stern lecture?
Nobody lectures me. Everyone tries, though. They try.
You should talk to somebody, Nathan.
Do not analyze me! I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Caulfield.
Take a step back, Nathan Prescott.
Seriously.
Oh, man. You're telling me what to do?
Get away from her, dude!
Ooh.
Hey! Leave him alone!
Nobody tells me what to do! Not my parents, not the principal,
that.
Or that whore right in the bathroom!
You got off easy.
Max? Chloe?
No way.
Blue hair is Chloe?
You again.
Go! Go! I got this!
Ow.
Get in, Max!
You got this? You're getting your head beat
Max,
in.
Get your punk asses out of there now! Don't even try to run! Nobody! Nobody!
Meanwhile, Mr. Security Guard just looks at him.
Man, Nathan Prescott is messed up and dangerous. This day never ends.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield. Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
Hopefully nothing after today. So, how do you know Nathan?
He's just another Arcadia asshole. Your friend really took a beatdown for you.
Warren?
Yeah, seriously.
Yeah, I owe him big time.
You're not the only one in debt. And you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
Not horrible, I guess, but...
I guess. It was cool, but I felt kind of lonely, out of my league.
I would think you'd fit right in with the art school hipsters.
Right. You look like the cover of hipstergirl.com.
At least you're still a smartass.
That's why I'm here.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Only for Mark Jefferson. No.
Of course, it's one of the best photography programs in the country. And my favorite teacher, Mark Jefferson.
So you came back to Arcadia for a teacher, not your best friend.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
That is true. She wanted to, just didn't know what to say. I guess start with an apology.
I'm sorry. I know things were tough on you when I left.
How do you know? You weren't even here.
I didn't order my parents to move specifically to fuck you over, Chloe.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max.
Fucking blue hair. No. I doubt anyone here gets that reference. When did that happen?
Man, are you serious?
Wow, haven't heard that one in a while.
Not everything changes. Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it in my place.
I need very specific tiny tools.
Nerd alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage. And he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max.
Well, I guess then we're going to the step douche's house.
Come on in. Don't be shy.
The house still looks nice.
Home, shit, home.
Birdie. Hello, Birdie. Okay, goodbye, Birdie.
My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill-out zone. My step-fuhrer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door. Put on some music while I medicate.
Ah. Medication, you say. Alright, I guess I'll put on some music for you.
It won't play without any power.
Oh, I need power? Oh. I should probably put on the power then. There you go. Now I'll put this on for you.
Houston, we have the power. But we need to find a disc to play.
Damn, this... in depth? I don't want to explore. You medicate.
Damn, Chloe does need a lot of money to get out of Arcadia.
3,000 for what? Okay, timing belt. Water pump. Flush cooling system. Tensioner. Fuel pump replacement, radiator replacement, alternator replacement, cylinder head gasket. Let's see. Parts and labor. $1,847 for labor. Doesn't exactly break it down by hour, though. This mechanic is ripping her off. I mean, it's a lot of work. But, let's see, $138 on labor for an alternator. On that type of truck, that should be right on top. So why such an odd number? Huh. Oh, well. Anyway. Not that I know anything about that kind of stuff.
I wonder what Chloe keeps in here.
Pictures? It says right on the box, Max. Come on.
Look at that. Chloe and her dad were so close.
I'm guessing not step douche.
Hey, that TV used to be in the living room.
So what's there now? All right, where do I find your music? I'm assuming it's over here in the drawer, maybe? Postcard.
This postcard is from Rachel Ember.
Everyone knew this fucking girl. Miss you, wish you were here, Rach. Seaside, Oregon.
Man, I remember this furniture. We spent all day painting it blue. Chloe loved that blue.
I like blue myself.
We had such a blast drawing this together.
With Chloe and Max, She's a Killer. Starring Kitty Cat. Director Mark Murlock, Warner Sis, instead of Warner Bros. That's awesome. Power Girls, Max and Chloe, and Super Kitty. Where is Super Kitty?
This looks like a laundry bag.
Let's search your laundry bag.
And it reeks like dirty laundry. Gross.
Damn it, Chloe, wash your drawers.
Cardboard boxes.
Fuck off my head. Alrighty.
Dude, you brought my glass snow dough. Thanks.
Well, not like,
Damn. Chloe was kicked out of Blackwell 2 years ago.
Oh, wow.
She used to be a great student. When she cared.
I'm just looking for the music, dude. There. I fixed your fucking snow globe. Let's see. Fine. I'll just fire around your laptop then. So you want to tell me
Too
where the music
I can't
is?
I'm streaming music from Chloe's laptop.
I'll just
but
fuck with your.
But I love how funky and outdated it is.
I'll just
she
fuck
even
with your
covered
shit.
In punk stickers because Chloe doesn't give a shit. She looks super happy. She looks super sad. She looks super stoned.
I don't know. I kind of missed that boat. I never really got into the whole high school burnout thing. It just
Is this a desk or a storage space?
It never really appealed to me, so.
I think this junk swallowed her desks. So it was Chloe who printed all those flyers.
Is there anything in the trash can?
Chloe's trash overfloweth.
Do you have discs in here?
Who'd have thunk Chloe wouldn't pay her parking tickets? She does love trouble.
Yeah. Super cool. Anywho.
Okay, Chloe, a metal box under the bed equals secret.
I'm going in. You might have some discs in there. There, see? Discs, I knew it. Ah.
Hey, give me that.
Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
Putting it mildly.
If you'd have told me where the hell the CDs were.
That's Rachel Ember. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
Yeah, I put them up. She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
I never forgot, even if I was an asshole and didn't keep in touch. But you had Rachel.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
So what happened? Did your folks, your mom, try to stop you?
My mom was too busy hooked up with Sergeant Shithead.
I feel the love. Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
How do you know? What about her parents?
What about her parents? Are they looking for her?
They're in denial. Max, I know she's missing.
I assume you know more than that.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. And poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now?
After I totally harshed her vibe, I'm gonna keep looking through the box.
Okay, Chloe, a metal box under the bed equals secret.
I'm still looking.
Nothing but junk in this suitcase. Chloe's dad built this dresser. Chloe totally changed her style. I barely recognized her.
Do you still not recognize her as...
Chloe was always taller than me. We made her dad keep track of her height.
Oh,
this is a flashback to youth. Our super secret closet lair.
Let me see. Well, I have the music now. I guess I could...
Hard to believe Chloe was my BFF just 5 years ago.
Let's see what bitchy remarks she has when I talk to
can
her.
Can you please put on some jams?
Golly. All right. Fine. Hobag. Hobag was a big stream. Grumpass. There you go. Grumpass. Oh, I love this song. She would burn to this song.
Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment. My step-ass keeps tools down in the garage. I bet you can find something to fix your camera.
Maybe I want to jam too. I like this song. God damn it. Well, you just have to deal with my ass, because I'm going to listen to the song for a minute.
We used to dare each other to climb down, but never did. You tell me stories
of the sea. Is there a way I can get that box down without breaking that?
Old cardboard boxes.
I don't think there is a way. I know that's where her grades are for Blackwell. Alright, whatever. I guess we'll come back. I really do love this song, though.
I shouldn't bug Chloe now. Plus, I need those tools.
All right, all right. Maybe I'll fuck with her and turn off the power. I'm such a dick. Okay, fine. Ooh, poster. I didn't realize that before.
I'm not into them. Too pretentious.
Okay, fine then. Oh, well. Off I go. Oh, I didn't have to stay in there. Good.
You can't go home again, said Thomas Wolfe. But here I am.
But he was right, because it's different now. Yeah, stuff.
Whoa, dark. I cannot see anything.
How about you turn on the light then?
This is definitely Joyce's makeup. Chloe wouldn't use animal products.
I wasn't sure the music would follow me. I'm glad it is.
I wonder if Chloe is taking those pills. I hope she's okay.
Fluoxetine tablets. I don't know what that is.
I like Chloe's new hair color. She's the opposite of shy. Of me.
I don't think there's anything else in here. How much do I weigh? Oh well. That'd have been awesome if it, like, reacted at least. Oh, sorry. Let me turn off your light. There, no. In there, no. Chloe's room. Can't go back in there. Alright. What's in here? I'm snooping.
This must be Chloe's parents' room. Man, I am nosy today.
Yep. Oh.
Oh, shit. Poor thing. I bet I could do something to save it.
Totally can. Oh, I guess I gotta go further back. Ah. I went too far. Ah. Ah. Hello? I saved you, Birdie. What'd you think about that?
You've been resurrected, Birdie. Fly, be free.
Hope you don't mind. There's a bird in your house now.
Uh-oh. Oh, the prices are late on their bills.
Oy. Mortgage statement. $4,300. That's not good. Turn that on. I want to look at the photo. Come on.
Joyce looks happy. Chloe's stepdad might not be a douchebag after all.
Do you not recognize who's in the picture, Max? We'll turn the lamp back off. I'm snooping.
Joyce still works at the diner. And Chloe's new dad is a security guard. Uh-oh.
Yep. Fine. There you go. Finally connected.
Dog tags. Sweet. David Mattson. Act, React, or Die. A 21st Century Survival Guide. Whoa, apocalypse self-help.
A bit much. But to each their own. Magazine.
Joyce always loved her mail order catalogs of useless crap. Aww. Joyce has a little shrine to William. Her new husband may not be such a douche.
At least there's that. Okay. Am I going to reclose that? No, I don't think I want to leave it closed. You should be able to get out. I'm going to leave it open. You fly out whenever you feel so inclined, Mr. Birdie. A necklace.
Oh my. Chloe made this for Joyce on Mother's Day years ago. I see why she would keep it.
Well, of course. All right. Peace out, Birdie. Don't get shot or anything. I have a feeling he would do stuff like that. Just a feeling. Going downstairs. Alrighty. The garage should be right there. Here's the front door. Here's the rest of the house. Okay. I'm assuming we are still in the middle of chapter one. Again, trying to stick with the habit of not running too long on these videos lately, so I'm going to go ahead and start winding down from here. So yes, we have just discovered that Officer David Matson is actually the security guard at Blackwell Academy, who is also, I think it said corporal, if I read that dog tag correctly. Also, Chloe's step douche, as she refers to him so affectionately. So this has just become much more problematic than I originally thought it was going to be. I'm just playing along. I totally played, like I said, I played this game about 7 years ago, so I remember some elements, not everything, but some. Like that headbutt was nasty. That poor Warren had to eat from Nathan. So here we are in the Price's residence, just kind of strolling down memory lane for now before we get to the garage and start fixing the camera. So just kind of snooping around, checking things out, and we saved a birdie. We are indeed a hero. Not the one that the birdie deserved, but the one that is here right now. So thank you everybody for watching. I'm Team Bravo 615. It's been real. It's been fun. It's been real fun. And I will see you on the next video. Bye-bye.